Hi guys, how's it going? This is Scott from Scott's Bass Lessons. In this tutorial, I'm going to be talking about soloing using only chord tones. Well, it's actually an exercise where you only use chord tones. Now, I'm not one of these guys that, you know, I'm not anti-scale at all. I use scales a lot. I use pentatonics. I use arpeggios. I use chord tones. I use everything. I think simply to think in one way is rather foolish, you know. I think if you're studying music, you should study everything out there. Study the arpeggios, study the chord tones, the scales, the pentatonics, the arpeggios, whatever you've got, you know, it's all for free. You just need to study it. So, but this exercise I'm going to take you around is something I really like to give my students, because it kind of condenses a lot of material down and makes sure that you know what you should do before you start progressing. So one thing you should do is you should know your chord tones before you start to try and solo. You should really sort of like try and visualise them on the neck. For this exercise, I'm going to use the standard Autumn Leaves. Now, the exercise is really simple. I want you to solo around a standard, a jazz standard, using only chord tones. You can only use chord tones, and not only that, you can only stay in one position. Okay, so the position I've chosen is I'm going to put my first finger on the 12th fret, okay, so these four frets here, and I'm allowing myself a fret either side of them four frets, so six frets in total, okay, and I'm going to create a solo. Now, it won't be the greatest solo, but it'll be, you know, I'm just trying to create a tasteful solo using chord tones only. No passing tones, no enclosures, no scales, just chord tones, okay? So, let's see how I do.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2.
So there you can see it's not the most mind-blowing solo in the world, but it's I'm trying to be really creative with what I've got, and more importantly, I'm trying to stick in this area, making sure I really know the harmony, the chords under my fingers. That's the most important thing, okay? So for instance, this starts with a C minor chord to F7 to B flat 7, major 7 to E flat to A half diminished to D7 to G minor to G7 and onwards. So my point is, and my exercise is, find a location on the fretboard, okay, 4 frets, 1 fret either side. You can only play a solo using chord tones in that area, okay? So let's see if you can do that. Hopefully you've enjoyed this exercise, or this lesson that I've given you, and I'm sure I'll see you soon. Take it easy. Get in the shed.